Hey everyone, welcome back to Biology in a Box. Today, we are going to be learning about inherited traits. Do you have freckles? Whether or not you have freckles, as well as many other traits you possess, are the results of dominant and recessive alleles. Dominant and recessive alleles are different forms of the same gene. These alleles are inherited from your parents and determined before you were born. A dominant allele is one that is always seen if at least one copy of it is present. And a recessive allele is one whose trait is only observed if a child gets two copies of the recessive allele, one from each parent. If a child gets a dominant allele from one parent, and a recessive allele from the other parent, the trait that is coded by the dominant allele masks the trait coded by the recessive allele. For example, freckles are the result of a dominant allele, while a lack of freckles is a recessive trait, which is two recessive alleles. Many traits that humans possess are inherited. So, how likely is it that a person will end up with a certain trait? Today, in today's exercise, find a partner to work with. You and your partner will be tossing two coins at a time onto a flat surface and recording how they land. You will need to make a table so you can show tally marks in the correct column to indicate how the coins landed for each toss. The table should look something like this. I flipped heads, and let's say that my partner flipped tails. For this toss, a tally mark would go in the heads-tails column. When you have finished tossing the coins and recording the results a total of 50 times, find the total number of tallies for each column. The three totals should have a sum of 50. Then, find the percentage of each combination of tosses. For example, if 14 out of the 50 tosses were heads-heads, to find the percentage, divide 14 by 50 and you'll get 0.28. Then multiply that by 100 and that gets 28. This means that 28% of the total tosses were heads-heads. Do the same for each total number of tosses for each of the three possible combinations. Once you have your three percentages, double-check your answers by adding them all up together. The sum of those percentages should equal 100 to represent the whole set of tosses. How do your percentages for the different combinations compare? Do the three percentages vary much in size? How do your percentages compare to the other group's percentages? Are they similar? Thank you for watching and learning with Biology in a Box.